Have you ever looked at a diagram of the building blocks of all matter, the atom, and thought, that's pretty interesting, kind of looks like our solar system, doesn't it? See how the planets move around the sun? Yeah, that's kind of like the nucleus and the neutrons and protons that comprise it. Hey, that's pretty cool, right? But have you ever thought about the actual extent of this orbital function? Have you ever thought that somewhere, somehow, if you kept stripping away the layers, a single atom could perhaps comprise an entire universe separate to our own, and in turn, our universe would then be merely an atom that perhaps makes up the bark on some tree in a distant, impossible dimension. Whoa, feeling weirded out yet? Yeah, hold on to your hats. Hello internet, what's going on? And once again, welcome back to the most inquisitive channel on YouTube, Life's Biggest Questions. As per usual, I'll be your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch, as today, we curiously ask the question, what if our universe is an atom? Roll the clip. For the curious amongst you, that clip was, of course, from the finale of 1997's Men in Black, which is perhaps the one scene that you all had in mind before you clicked on this video, right? Maybe? I don't know. I can't read your minds, that'd be ridiculous. But either way, for many of us, that scene was indeed the first visual representation of the idea that we're going to outline in this next Life's Biggest Question, where the universe wasn't only caught in a bauble around the neck of a cat, but was also, at the same time, a marble being used in a game by an alien child. Again, trippy, right? That sounds like quantum entanglement to me, but what do I know? Also, any chance we get to show that movie, we'll take, because come on, it's awesome. Now, listen, to even begin to approach this question, we're going to have to do a little bit of mental gymnastics and vault up to this incredibly broad idea from both a scientific and philosophical perspective. You see, from a scientific perspective, the answer to this question is incredibly simple. No. Or, well, we don't know, given the fact that under the current scientific model, there is no evidence, theoretical or otherwise, to support the fact that there is a universe inside each nucleus of an atom, and in turn, our own universe being one of those atoms in an infinite kaleidoscope of universes and atoms, which is a mind-boggling thought in its own right, and perhaps we should slow down, but that's by the by. You see, even if someone somewhere managed to crunch the parameters behind such a notion, the extent of it would be even more mind-boggling. If each nucleus of an atom did have a universe contained inside of it, then the number of universes inside of this already expanding universe, which it is expanding, would be unimaginable. And then in turn, would all of those micro-universes then also be composed of atoms, and then do each of those contain another universe within its nucleus? Yeah, you can see where this is going, right? The fact that we can say no to this question from the off, though, is down to one thing. We already know that the nucleus of an atom has a finite number of subatomic particles, protons and neutrons, whose weight is definitive and whose quantity is known. We know that. But within the infinite parameters of what this notion would propose, knowing the quantity of something is in direct opposition to that. The universe and the galaxies within it are made up of hundreds of billions of stars, more than the number of quarks in a nuclei, which we are already aware of. We also know another thing that dismisses this. The forces that hold an atom together, part of the four forces of fundamental interaction, are the strong force and the electromagnetic force. Now, in our current understanding of physics, the strong force can only work on really small distances, and the electromagnetic force is even more specific, which acts as the interaction between charged particles. Basically, in the laws of the very small, they're the things that keep atoms together. But if we apply that to this hypothetical notion, where our universe and thus every solar system within it act on the same principles as an atom, that's where a clear contradiction lies. The distance between galaxies, as we all know, is quite large. Yeah, just tell that to NASA, it's a pretty big distance, and thus the strong force has already been eliminated. It just couldn't exist. The other nail in the coffin is that the simple fact is, galaxies do not have an electrical charge, making the second force insignificant too. So yeah, there goes electromagnetic force as well. You see, our understanding of the universe is split into two very clear and important camps. The science of the very big, the macro, or the solar systems and galaxies that comprise our universe, and the science of the very small, the study of the subatomic and quantum mechanics. The science of the very big is illustrated perfectly by classical physics and Sir Isaac Newton's laws of motion, which defines how and why things move the way that they move, planets and solar systems included. However, the crossover between the science of the very big and the science of the very small eludes us, because we know that these same laws of physics drastically change when things are extremely small to when they are extremely big. This crossover is known as the theory of everything, a theory which doesn't yet exist and is the holy grail of physicists and the curious minds of our species. Now, in the application of this hypothetical situation, in the notion of our universe being a universal myriad of the subatomic level, it is clearly contradicted. At the subatomic level, things become erratic and uncertain. Concepts like position, speed, and motion completely lose their meaning. Things pop in and out of existence, as is the case with quantum entanglement. Particles can exist in two places at the same time. And whilst that's pretty run-of-the-mill in the quantum state, in the macro, yeah, we know that two identical things can't exist in the same place at the same time, in different places and at different times. And so all of these models, all of these clearly defined phenomena that scientists have painstakingly devoted the study of their lives to, quickly defeat the notion of our universe existing within the same principles of the atom. Case closed. Show's over, folks. But there is also one thing that we do know. We know nothing. Well, not exactly nothing, because that would discredit the genius of the brilliant minds that have already established our very clear understanding of what we do know about the macro and the micro. But surely we can't be certain about everything, because then we would have, well, the theory of everything. You see, it's human nature for us to look for a pattern in things, which is why the notion of our solar system, and thus the universe, resembling the function of the atom is so clearly compelling. However, although a beautiful and romantic notion, and again deep within the fabric of our cosmos, the hidden secrets of dark matter, dark energy, black holes, the Higgs boson, and many other things that we don't know could add some form of enlightenment to what we think we know about the nature of the universe. But right now, there are just too many contradictions for us to accept any form of truth behind it. That is the purpose of science. We do know one thing though: in the pursuit of bridging the gap between the science of the very small and the science of the very big, the only thing that awaits us is looking at the universe from a completely different perspective. And that's an exciting thought, isn't it? Well, there we have it, our long and short answers to the question, what if our universe is an atom? What do you guys think? Do you agree, disagree, have any intriguing insights to add? Then let us know your thoughts down in the comment section below. Before we depart from today's video, let's first take a quick look at some of your more creative comments from over the past few days. Ray Casser says, I don't care what they say, Pluto is a planet, it's just a baby. Ah, that's a sweet thought, isn't it? You know what? I think you might be right there, Ray. Yeah, you go get him, Pluto. Well, on that note, unfortunately, that's all we've got time for in today's video. Cheers for sticking around all the way until the end. If you were a fan of this video or just Life's Biggest Questions in general, then please be a dear and hit that thumbs up button, as well as that subscribe bell. And I'll be seeing you in the next one. As per usual, I've been your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch. You've been watching Life's Biggest Questions. And until next time, you take it easy.